Well, as we celebrate the 100th anniversary of military aviation, we take a look at the Coast Guard's unique place in the history of flight. And Coast Guard Petty Officer Adam Eggers speaks with the service's longest tenured aviator.
The U.S. Coast Guard's involvement in aviation can actually be traced back to 1903, when the Wright brothers made their famous December flight, with the help from the crew of the nearby life-saving station. To find out more about the Coast Guard's aviation history, we spoke with someone who was a part of that history.
When I came in the Coast Guard, it was in the olden days, in the 1970s, and I was one of the first classes that had women in it, in OCS. And we hadn't quite figured out what we were going to let women do. So I applied for flight school, and I was told, well, we don't send women to flight school. So that then became a challenge, and with great support, eventually we got that door broken down.
Vice Admiral Crea also happens to be the highest-ranking female in the history of the armed services, as she serves as second in command of the Coast Guard. But one of her most special designations is that of the service's Ancient Albatross.
What it means is I am the person in the Coast Guard who got their wings longest ago. So to go full circle from being told I couldn't do it to being the Ancient Albatross is kind of fun.
Throughout the years, Coast Guard aviators have distinguished themselves as skilled pilots, dodging enemy fire in both World Wars and Vietnam, to dangerous rescues at sea in some of the worst conditions imaginable.
Well, it's the same way as our small boat community and our ships. We do hazardous work in a dangerous environment. When you can save a life, it is the most thrilling feeling in the whole world, and it carries you over for the rest of your life. When you lose one, it's just a feeling of great despair.
She is also part of Coast Guard aviation lore, and although it may sound like a joke, it's actually a true story.
When I was in Barbers Point, we were doing a trial project in which we had three pigeons in a round bubble mounted on the bottom of the helicopter. And you had a pigeon in each half and then a pigeon in the back. These pigeons had been trained over at the Marine lab to peck when they saw something orange. Theoretically, an orange life jacket they would peck, and that would give you the sensor that, oh, the left pigeon saw it, or the right pigeon saw it, or the pigeon, you know, looking behind saw it.
One innovation that is no joke came in 1983 with the creation of the Coast Guard Rescue Swimmer Program. Up until that time, survivors had to get themselves into the rescue basket. That all changed with a congressional mandate following the Marine Electric tragedy, in which 31 crew members died because they were too hypothermic to climb into the basket themselves.
Go ahead, deploy swimmers.
Roger. Deploying swimmer. Swimmers away.
Vice Admiral Crea is one of the few Coast Guard pilots to fly both fixed-wing aircraft and helicopters.
I just feel extremely fortunate to have had that opportunity, again, to see this full spectrum of Coast Guard aviation and the difference that they make in terms of the end game and the conditions that they fly in.
Coast Guard pilots have left their historical mark on military aviation, from piloting the first transatlantic flight to pioneering the use of helicopters. As today's Coast Guard aviators grow in prominence with every hurricane, rescue case, and drug interdiction, we can't forget that chilly December day back in 1903. Coast Guard Petty Officer Adam Eggers, Pentagon Channel News.